Asian equities saw muted trade as the second quarter and first half draw to a close. Investors continue to grapple with a higher-for-longer rate environment and looming recession. Weak factory activity data from China also stoking expectations of fresh stimulus from the government. In all, a gauge of global equities are headed for about 12% gain in the first half, with Japan's TOPIX index enjoying an over 20% advance since the start of the year, Chinese equities remaining in the red, while India's Nifty 50 saw a more than 5% gain in the first 6 months. As for Philippine shares, down for the day by nearly 0.75%, down for the quarter by 0.5%, and off by 1.5% year to date.
There isn't much risk premium to for an a foreign investor to put their money in the Philippines, only point a risk premium of 0.75%. So they'd rather put their money in the U.S. Since the U.S. Obviously has a relatively lower risk compared to an emerging nation like the Philippines.
Trading edges Ronacoba sees more of the same in the next 6 months.
The PSEI will continue to trade sideways within a range. Within a tight range. As in the past month, if you remember during my last visit here, trading will continue to be dictated by the monetary policy environment in the US and here in the Philippines. More specifically, a divergence of policies between the BSP and the Fed will continue to discourage any significant institutional inflows, especially foreign inflows from coming in. The US continuing to raise rates, the BSP pausing and switching to dovish mode, it will continue to divert foreign flows to away from emerging nations and back to developed nations.
In corporate stories, amid outrage over flight delays and cancellations over a shortage in planes, Cebu Pacific received today its 8th aircraft delivery for the year, a brand new A320neo. This is also Cebu Pacific's first China-assembled Airbus jet. The Gokongwei-led budget carrier is looking to accept 15 aircraft this year. The carrier currently has a 62-unit fleet. The A320neo is 20% more fuel efficient and uses sustainable aviation fuel that translates to an up to 80% reduction in carbon emissions. Meanwhile, Robinsons Land listed 15 billion pesos in fixed-rate bonds at the PDEX. This is the second and final tranche of its shelf-registered 30 billion from August 2022. This is also the first fully oversubscribed offering by a local company this year. RLC priced at the tightest of spreads, locking in rates of 6.0972% per annum for the 3-year tenor and 6.1663% per annum for the 5-year tenor. Proceeds will be used to fully repay maturing debt and partially fund CapEx for the year. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.